Wow, welcome to Full Stop in the Wow, where we are taking such an intense, aggressive approach to our situation, our problem, that it brings up this wow feeling. And then we have to cope with this wow feeling. So we full stop in the wow. We're patient. We let ourselves adjust. Our quote-unquote sickness is so extreme, actually. We need to do very intense therapy for it. And this is what we do here. I'm already in the wow mode from this morning. Stupendous. Another stupendous breakthrough, actually, which I expect at this time. Now, this may not be for everyone. All right, it may not be for everyone. There's some people who just say, that's fine. But it might be for you. All it means is you spend time sitting quietly, adjusting to this, the intensity of this approach. Can we afford some less intensity approach? I don't know. And when you have like a very malignant situation, the approach has to be super intense. You can't fool around. And what I've been saying for a long time is we're building up towards greater and greater and greater intensity of troubles. And this next 18 months, starting in December, we say December 21st, 2014, starting then, next 18 months to the 21st of June in 2016, it is going to be an extraordinarily problematical time, which is going to put a lot of people into states of agitation and confusion. So we don't want to be like that. We want to be actually in a state of perfect calm. And we can be in a state of perfect calm, absolutely. But we're not going to get there by fooling around. I've already had a very nasty illness starting on the 8th of January this year, and I've had to up my efforts and get very serious about this in order to push it back a little bit. Now, people say, why don't you go to a doctor? Because that's not serious enough. That's not a serious enough, intense enough approach. That's just fooling around. Taking medicine is just fooling around, actually. This situation that we have is way deeper than those kind of superficial modalities of treatment. This has to be treated in an extraordinarily intensive way, which is really through right affirmation. And when you do right affirmation, you get this wow, because it succeeds. And you say, well, I'm not quite sure I'm ready to succeed yet. Yeah. Of course, the alternative is we're going to get swept away in the hysteria of the times. This is being taped in the Silicon Valley of California. And California is like a bellwether state in terms of what's going on in the greater world, always has been. And here we have a very intense situation, which is lack of water. It doesn't get much more intense than that. And we had a 2-week period in December where it rained, and we said, oh great, maybe we can, stop, there hasn't been a trace of it since. In fact, today it's like summer here. And we're saying, uh-oh, yeah. We cannot withstand another year of drought in California without devastating consequences to the state, to the economy, to the morale, to everything. So you talk about agitation, hysteria, and you talk about quote-unquote being able to predict stuff. Well, here's a perfect example of if there is no rain and there is no water, and you check the reservoirs, and you start going into the dry season, you can know beyond almost any doubt whatsoever that there's going to be severe problems. And you can predict that ahead of time. You see that? So it's a perfect example of how you can predict the future in many ways, actually. You know what the variables are. So if we don't get water in California, you can be sure there is going to be hell to pay in this state. And not only the state, the western region, the Rocky Mountains. If the Rocky Mountains don't get any rain, there's not going to be any runoff into the Colorado River, which means there's no water going into Lake Mead, the various lakes there, the Hoover Dam. And the Hoover Dam level of the water, the Hoover Dam, they have to keep using the water. At some point, it certainly will drop below the intake tubes that go to the turbines that generate all the electricity that go to Phoenix, Los Angeles, Las Vegas, massive amount of energy. There's no water going through there if there's not any runoff from the Rocky Mountains. So you're talking about a seismic problem. You're talking about a huge problem. So along with all the stuff that's coming out of Silicon Valley, that is, you know, fundamentally altering the very fabric of society. And it goes on and on and on and on and on. So These are the times, drastic times. These are drastic times. And so what I've done is I've prepared for this ahead of time to be able to give right advice and support for what's the right modality of treatment for these times. And what we need to do is we need to treat our mind. And fortunately for us, the Holy Spirit and Jesus have shown me bit by bit by bit. I'm getting clearer and clearer and clearer. There most certainly is a way. There most certainly is a way. And here we're all over it. So full stop in the wow here, full stop in the wow. So we've talked about in the past the approaches to take. We have a basic fallback position. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. This is a fundamental center of affirmation that we have. Whenever we seem to be wandering and lost, we just go right back to that. Now, we also have this practice of dropping our train of thought. As soon as we recognize a train of thought, without any delay, drop it. Without any delay. This is what's important. Don't say, well, I want to see how this train of thought develops. Or let me develop this scenario, fantasy scenario, a little further. Or let me see how this... No. We simply recognize it and then, boom, instantly drop it. Or as quickly as we possibly can. Try to be instantly. Don't give it any time at all. Thirdly, we practice, we say, relax our mind, release our thoughts, and let them go. Don't value what is valueless, and we're practicing feeling okay about dropping all reaction to this world and to bodies and to time, space, process, and form, of just letting it all go. This is something I've been starting to work on now. And then fourthly, the practice, very important practice of, instead of saying, I will be enlightened, I know I will be enlightened, we're shifting gears now in 2:15 and we're saying, I'm already enlightened. I know I'm already enlightened. Now, I've been practicing this for a month. Finished. I know I'm already timeless. I know I'm already formless. And as much as possible, accept this, that this is not just a petition. It is actually, you're stating from the awareness, your own awareness, you're stating, this is how I am actually. I'm already enlightened. Which means all this other stuff has just been a silly wish fantasy, actually. Okay, so we've gone over those. There's one more that has come up now. This is very, very, very important. You say, I'm already free. I know I'm already free. I know that I've already done it. I've already done it. Whatever it is, I've already done it. See, it's something that's already accomplished now. So when we say, I've already accomplished it, I know I've already accomplished this. It's already done. Then we can say, I don't need to do it faster. It's already done. I don't need to do it slower. It's already done. I don't need to do it smarter. It's already done. I don't need to do it more skillfully. It's already done. I know it's already done. So I don't need to do it faster. I know it's already done. What is already done is done. Finished with it. I'm already finished with it. So all of these categories of doing it faster, doing it in a different, I don't need to do it in a different way. It's already done. I don't need to do it in some other way. It's already done. I don't need to think about doing it. It's already done. I don't need to plan to do it. It's already done. I don't need to worry about doing it. It's already done. I don't need to get help in doing it. It's already done. I don't need to wait to do it. It's already done. What we're doing here is what is releasing what's called the personality. What we think of as the personality is all these strategies of maybe I should do it quicker or not so quick or a little more, a little less. And these are the patterns of our personality. But you see, we don't need any of those patterns anymore. Personality patterns. Because it's already done. I know I'm already enlightened, so I don't need to do it faster. It's already done. I don't need to put more effort into it. It's already done. I don't need to put less effort into it. It's already done. So as we practice this way, it begins to dawn on us, hey, this is what I really want. So we're left with what is still personality. We still have a personality, but it's still, it's calm. All of this jumble of stuff that we call a personality, it can just be carried off by the breeze, never to return. I don't need it. I don't need my personality. I don't need any of this personality. See, my personality just is this jumble of strategies. And maybe I need to do it a little faster, a little slower, a little more effort, a little less effort, be a little smarter, maybe be a little smoother, or maybe more ferocious, or maybe intermittent, you know, all this blueprint of strategies we have. And yet, I don't need any of those strategies. I'm already finished. I know I'm already finished. So this hit me with a wow this morning, as hit me right now. This is just fabulous. Obviously, this is a key to personality transformation. You just realize you don't need any of that stuff. It's like you're already awake. Why do you need any strategies of how to awake? You're already awake. See? I don't need to do it stronger. I'm already done. I don't need to do it weaker. I know it's already done. I don't need to do it more gently, it's already done. I don't need to do it more ferociously, it's already done. So this is the first I've seen this, I said. Yeah, this is a huge, another progression here, very important. So that brings with it the wow. Absolutely, it does. It's the concept. I mean, this is just tremendous, right? Because all of this agitation we call personality, this struggle, don't need it. I don't need to struggle with it. I know I've already done it. I know I'm already finished. So I don't need to struggle. I know I've already finished. I don't need to think about it, I've already finished. I don't need to think about how to do it, I've already finished. What we call our lives we've been living is just a struggle to try to figure out how to do it. And yet, I'm saying, I know I've already done it. And in order to frame it in our mind, which is used to words and concepts and ideas and structuring, so we use these words, which is fine, not a problem. Don't try to outsmart yourself. Because we're speaking from the standpoint of attainment or doing something, which is what we're so totally used to. So for the sake of the continuity, fear, and problem, we use this type of terminology. But we certainly get the point of it. Absolutely. It means we don't need any of this struggle. It means we can let it go. To revisit this problem. I know I've already finished with it. I'm already finished with it. I don't need to come back later. I know I'm already finished with it. I've already finished it. even know I've already done. I don't need to take a rest before I try again. I know I'm already finished. I don't need to try again. I'm already finished with it. I don't need to work at it. I'm already done with it. So we're just introducing this now. But I can certainly feel the potency of this. And what we do is full stop in the wow, is we recognize that this is a very stunning development. And we don't try to push it too fast or too far. We just start to get acquainted. And we recognize this wow. There's part of us that's just like quite astonished. And actually very excited about it, because we're recognizing, oh, this is it. So we have to temper that excitement and let it calm down a little bit, or else it'll get a little bit too ragged for us. We just say, we use our will to say, yeah, okay, we'll just sit here quietly. Full stop. Part of us is saying, this is it. This is it, the secret I've been looking for. This is the answer I've been looking for. Wow. So we need to not project that. Don't project success. This full stop means don't project success. Just stay with the immediacy of the wow right now. Don't start thinking about how great it's going to be not to have to struggle with a personality anymore, not to have any struggle anymore. But don't project that success. This is the discipline we have here. The faster you go, the more you have to discipline yourself in the wow, full stop in the wow, and don't project success. So all important. I try to not do that at all costs. Do not start thinking about how wonderful everything is going to be and how successful, when just, you know, the whole your life in the future, how, don't do it. Don't get ahead of yourself. You see that in sports teams, I notice. As soon as a sports team is doing really well, starts talking about, wow, you know, look at the success we're going to have. They start projecting, like, that's when they start falling apart. So you never want to do that. When you get wise, you just say, you stay humble. You say, well, you know, we won the game today, and that's all I can say. And tomorrow's another day. We're just grateful we played well today. That's it. Those are the teams that keep winning. So you don't want to get ahead of yourself. So what we say, hey, I know this is just like a tremendous wow right now. But this is just right now, and I'm just going to stay focused on right now. Don't project into the future. As again, the more success you have, the more important this is. It gets more and more difficult, you think, because, wow, you just say, good Lord, this is so all important. You know, I've discovered the secret to freedom. Yeah, I just, well, okay, don't get ahead of yourself. There have been many others who have already discovered this before, actually. They may not have described it quite in the same way, and it seems like descriptions are never quite the same based on a lot of different factors of speaking to culture, society at this particular time. But certainly many have discovered this already. to discover it within your own, you know, situation here is a big deal. It's a big deal, especially now, where this type of clarity is hard to come by for sure. So if you're making rapid progress, then you will be aware of this wow. You will be stunned by it. So that's why this discipline is so important. Wowism is for those who are going really fast. For those who are going very slowly, of course, they're not interested because they don't feel so intense, the wow so intensely. But when you're making major breakthroughs every day, then you most certainly have to manage your success. That becomes all important. Yeah, for instance, today I stayed in bed today till like 11:30 in the morning. Because I was working on this. And beautiful, incredible summer-like day in California. I'm sitting here taping, so I'm giving myself the opportunity to adjust to this progress here. These breakthroughs are monumental. I know I'm already enlightened. Well, then what about the personality? You see, I recognize I'm already finished, so I don't need any approach. I don't need any approach. I'm already enlightened. I don't need any approach. Personality is always about the approach. How are you approaching? You know, how are you functioning? What is your approach? And I don't need any approach. I'm already done. First time in 23 days, I haven't had a sore throat now. And the trouble is still lurking, so I have to keep working. And I feel very exhausted, weak. So it's been a big struggle, a severe fear, very severe fear. Taboos, when you break taboos, you feel this, you know, shock. Certainly breaking the taboo of approach is a huge shock to the system. I say, I'm already finished. I know I'm already finished. I don't need any approach at all. Super intense. I know I'm already finished. I don't need any approach at all. just a colossal game changer right here. I can feel it's reverberating throughout the whole psyche, the whole all structure, whatever structure there is. It's shaking and reverberating like a huge earthquake. So this is the managing of success. The price of success is you have to manage success. And if you're willing to pay that price, then your success will be ultimate when you realize, I don't need any success, I've already finished. I've already succeeded. I don't need any approach to success, I've already succeeded. I don't need any fear. I've already succeeded. I'm already finished. I don't need any fear. I know I've already finished. I'm gonna get a little noise here. I guess the guys are done with their lunch break. Yes, they are. Okay, that's all right. So, most importantly, I would advise everyone is to accept that you need a very aggressive, intense, aggressive approach. We'll say that term, whatever term we use, a treatment. We need a very aggressive treatment for what we realize is likely impending agitation. Like sitting here in California, everybody seems fine, you know, because it's still, you know, it's January 31st, 2015. But if you look ahead and say, wait a minute, you know, this high pressure ridge is in place, and we might not get much more rain. It's possible. You know, we're headed for agitation here. We're on the road to agitation right now in California. So then you think, hey, I can't just wait until the agitation is upon me, and I won't be prepared. So I better prepare now. I better go in a very, very intense treatment for this, so I will have a calm mind when the agitation strikes. That's an example. So the way to do that is to sit quietly. Sit quietly. Going to the dentist here. And be committed to managing your success, and that requires that you sit quietly and full stop in this wow. Because when you get after it, you start having great success. You keep shifting gears and going faster and faster and faster, and ultimately, it's like you break the sound barrier and you realize, I'm already finished. I know I'm already finished. And then you have to manage that success, and then you realize, I don't need any approach. I've already finished. And then you manage the success of that, you see, so. Also, I liken it to like taking a vacation out of the slums, and you decide, hey, you know, the slums are getting so bad, there's gonna be a plague in the slums, I gotta get out of here. And so you take a plane trip, and of course, where you first land, it's much better than the slums. You just came out of the worst slums, terrible. And you're like, wow, this is really fantastic, wow. And then you go to another place that's even better, and then another place that's even better. And you keep landing in better and better places, and you just like, every time you touch down, it's just, wow, this place is amazing. And you have to get used to it. So when you land down and land in a new place that's so amazing to you, you have to be pragmatic and realize, hey, I can't just go native right away. Those are already here, completely used to it already. I'm not. So I just need to sit quietly, you know, and just get used to it. Let's say you go to this amazing hotel with an interior that's just full of lush, beautiful gardens and waterfall. I mean, just butterflies. I mean, you think, wow. You come out in this place and just, oh my gosh, how beautiful. Look at this. Massive windows open to the ocean there, you know, and the beach. And just, oh. What you do is you just find a little corner, a little area. Well, maybe a little table, and just sit down and say, I think I'm going to have some tea, or I'm going to, you know, order a little food or something. And just unobtrusively, quietly, unobtrusively, you just sit there and you spend like hours at your little meal, you know, and drinking some water or a nice fruit juice drink or something, just slowly, and you just sort of slowly look around. Because everything is dazzling, you know, just like, wow, look at that view, look at this spaciousness, look at this place, it's just out of this world, it's fantastic. But just sip your food drink and nibble on your fries or whatever you have, or nibble on your hors d'oeuvres, and just spend some time just sitting there. Don't get up and walk around and try to act like you own the place, or yeah, I'm used to this place, I've been here a long time. No. You're a newbie, so act like a newbie. Because you're in shock. You're in shock. And after several days of doing this, being very humble, very unobtrusive, not drawing any attention to yourself, you slowly start to get into the rhythm of the place, and you start to walk around a little bit, staying humble, and gradually, you begin to feel like you belong here. That this is your new camp, your new home. Don't worry if some people are acting like they own the place, or, you know, they're acting out. Just stay humble, weak, humble, unassuming. Don't draw attention to yourself. Got this wonderful, don't bother us at all. Nuevo Mariachi band using power tools. The shock is, we realize I don't need a personality. I've already finished. I don't need any approach to finishing. I've already finished. Need to go faster, I've already finished. I don't need to work harder, I've already finished. I don't need to try, I've already finished. I don't need to keep trying, I've already finished. I don't need to keep practicing, I've already finished. And I mean practicing from a personality standpoint, obviously. Here, we need to get used to the fact. We need to practice getting used to the fact that we don't need to practice. We need to get used to the fact we don't need any results. I don't need any results. I've already finished. I don't need to work on attaining results. I've already finished. Of thinking concepts, belief in this way, you know, confounds the whole structure of belief. And so we feel this, wow. I don't need to find a way to finish. I know I've already finished. I don't need to search for answers, I've already finished. I don't need to search for answers, I'm already done. I'm already finished. I don't need to seek the way. I don't need to seek the way. I'm already finished. I know I'm already finished. We don't need this personality. This realization is, it reverberates. It's just, wow. Don't really know what to make of it. So just sit quietly. Don't have to make anything of it. And don't think that you're somehow just got off track because you're feeling this wow. No. Just let it subside a little bit. And then you'll realize you're right on track. to find a path I've already finished. I don't need to find a way to finish the path I've already finished. Estimation, this is what is appropriate given the world situation, which is one of intense time worshiping going on. And what I say is the tribulation period. We're told, as in the days of Noah, so shall it be in those times. Well, in the times of Noah was actually a tremendous amount of genetic manipulation, mixing of DNA, genetics between all sorts of different creatures. And everything we just do is just like, hey, if we can do it, let's do it. And so there's, you know, knowledge of DNA and genetics and how to mix them and art, you know, all this technology. Well, we have that right now. And there are laboratories crossing different animals right now. So we are in the times of Noah again, as it was in the times of Noah just before the deluge. So will it be in the times, end times of the tribulation time. Well, we're already here. So we most definitely need the most effective advice possible right now. And when we get that advice, it will be so successful, we'll be shocked by it. So this is why I say wowism is the approach of these times, which means your focus is full stop in this wow, because our success is so shocking. This is very shocking success for me. Stunning, because I feel just how all-encompassing it is. It's just wow. You want to know how bad the times are these days? Are even Tiger Woods can't even play golf anymore. The times are so bad. That's it. And he can't even chip or putt. I mean, I was watching him play. I said, hey, I can play like that. I mean, what's going on? This is bizarre. Totally bizarre. I mean, he's hitting an approach shot from 117 yards, a simple wedge shot, and he misses it by 40, 50 feet. And I was like, what? I can do better than that. Chipping, hits the chip shot, sculls him over the green into the bunkers. I'm like, God, this is like an amateur. You don't think the pressure's on in the world? I mean, Tiger Woods had the most skillful game I've ever seen. The most skillful game. The best touch I've ever seen. He's the last person in the world you'd ever think could possibly lose their touch like this. And I'm saying, I got better touch than that, or at least it's good. I can do that too. My guy, everyone's just like, what? It's not even professional grade, you know? Not even professional, right? That's just like very amazing, very stunning. So we have to be professional grade here with our approach, and the answer is, I don't need any approach because I've already finished. It's like somebody who's already won the tournament, and someone say, "Well, what kind of approach can you hit? Should you hit here on this green? And how are you going to do that?" I mean, how am I going to do it? I'm already done. I already won the tournament. I don't need to think about how am I going to win the tournament. I already won it. there is no next term. This is it. I'm retired. I'm retired. I don't need to figure out how to retire. I'm already retired. I already made it. I don't need to figure out how to make it. I already made it. Someone already makes the putt, turns us over, finished one. We don't have to think about it. How do I make this putt? How do I do it, Margaret? It's done. It's finished. I already made it. I don't have to think about it. How do I make it anymore? I don't have to think about it. How do I get light? I'm already light. I know I'm already enlightened, so I don't need an approach. I don't need a plan. I don't need a strategy. I don't need to think about it. I don't need to worry about it. I don't need to generate confidence. I don't need confidence. I'm already finished. I don't need bluster, I'm already finished. I don't need deception, I'm already finished. I don't need trickiness, I'm already finished. I don't need to do a dance, I'm already done. Agitation next, you can hear it next door, right? Here comes the agitation. Big time. It's not bothering me at all. It's like water off the duck's back. I don't need to worry about finishing. I've already finished. I know I've already finished. Now, there are those who may say, I can't do this. And they make excuses. Why? Because it's so successful. They don't know how to manage the success. But this is why I've taken the approach of full stop in the wow. This is why I said it's so important. You have to be able to manage your success in order to take this very effective approach like this. And it was just to say, I know I've already finished. I don't need any approach. I don't need to have any approach at all. I've already finished. You have to manage the success of this, and it's extreme. So sitting quietly in blocks of time like this is the most effective approach of all, because eventually you'll be able to handle the realization you don't need any approach. You don't need to learn to limit what doesn't exist because it already doesn't exist. Nothing already doesn't exist. We don't need to learn to limit nothing. It already is nothing. It already doesn't exist. I came in this dream, I came to the pearly gates. And someone was there. It's like, wow, how do we get through? We gotta somehow take this all down. And there was this, on the extreme right, there was just someone going through this little utility cart, and this little section on the far right of these pearly gates opened up like a little door. They went through, they came back through it, and they said, wow, we go right through like that. It's amazing. And I realized that these pearly gates are not built by God to keep us out of heaven. They're built by us to try to limit loss from getting into heaven. We built it to keep death out of heaven, to keep nothing out of heaven, you see. And then you realize nothing already is nothing. I don't need to learn to limit it. It's already non-existent. So I don't need these gates. I go right through. I don't need to do anything. I don't need this barrier. We don't need to learn to limit loss, because there is no loss in reality. Don't need to learn to limit nothing or time. Don't need to learn to limit time. It's already nothing. Nothing is already nothing. Nothing is already nothing. I've already finished. I don't need to collaborate. I don't need to collaborate to figure out how to do this. I've already done it. It's already done. This is very shocking, but you can get used to this shocking. Get used to it, and it's no longer shocking. And once that happens, you'll be able to take whatever the next step is, next realization is. Absolutely. There's no doubt about it. Right now, this is about as intense as I've ever experienced. Need to do anything. I know I'm already done. Wonder how can those go sit in a cave meditating for so long and be enlightened? You know, how they do that? Well, when you sit quietly and you're still and you give yourself these blocks of time like this, then automatically from within an idea will appear to you like, hey, how about this? How about this? And then you'll say, hey, let me try this. And you'll try it and you'll make more and more progress and then. Again, it's internal. It's within us, actually. Truth is within us. So when we give the truth the opportunity to arise and how we can manage our success, the success will come. So wherever you are, you may say, well, I don't have any teachers, no teacher here. But when you... You say, I don't need to go faster. I've already finished. I don't need to be more clever. I've already finished. I don't need to make better decisions. I've already Already done. I don't need to rest from my efforts. I've already finished. I don't need to rest to renew my efforts. I've already finished. I'm already done. I know I'm already done. So we're paying the price today for our success tomorrow, so to speak, by getting used to this. And we can say, I don't need tomorrow. I'm already done. And eventually realize we don't need a tomorrow. We don't even need a next hour. I don't need the next hour. I'm already finished. I don't need another hour to work on this. I'm already finished. I don't need another minute to work on this. I'm already done. I don't even need another second to work on this. I'm already done. I don't even need another moment to work on this. I'm already done. And so, because we have may not have ever thought in this way, ever considered this in this way, ever looked at it in this way, it's very stunning, very shocking. I'm shocked at being able to do this. Somewhat shocked, but from all the previous practice, it's in the ballpark. So I'm not, you know, overwhelmed, but it is certainly very stunning. Need to get well. I already am well. I'm already finished. I'm already perfect. I don't need to get well. I'm already perfect. I'm already well. I don't need to cure anything. I'm already finished. I'm already complete. I don't need to cure anything. I'm already complete. I don't need to be a guru. I already am a guru. See? I don't need to be a guru. In other words, to get that, get there. I already am a guru. I already am a guru. I already am. I don't need to be I am. In other words, do something to be I am. I already am. I don't need to do anything. I'm already finished. Full stop in the wild, full stop. Keep in mind, don't project in the future. Don't go parallel. parallel. Don't go in the past, the future. Just stay right with right now. I don't need right now. I already am right now. I don't need success. I'm already got success. I already am success. I am success. I don't need success. I already am success. I don't need to get freedom. I already am free. I don't need any strategy to get free. I'm already free. I don't need to work on freedom. I already am free. It's like you put an ice cube out in the sun and it's like a super hot day. You don't have, what do you have to worry about? You know it's going to melt. You just let it melt. So, sitting here is like being the ice cube. And those realizations are like the hot sun. So don't worry. The ice cube is going to melt. So I get agitated, like, well, how fast is it melting? You know, trying to watch paint dry, just let it dry. Again, getting used to this approach, which is what? I don't need any approach. I know I've already finished. I don't need any leap. I'm already done. I'm already here. You could say the fact that you realize you don't need any leap is the leap. Because our personality is all geared up. I don't need a personality, I'm already done. I don't need a leaper, I'm already done. I'm already here. So I don't need a leaper. I don't need a striver. I don't need a doer. I'm already here. I know that I'm already here. I know I'm already here, so I don't need a doer, or a striver, or a attainer, or a leaper. So, there may be some of the world who think, oh, they're just waiting and some all-powerful teacher, guru, savior will come and just bless them and that's done. No. Everyone has to learn to manage their success. Otherwise, they'll come undone. They'll get ahead of themselves, start acting out. And so, those who have been sitting quietly still, this allows, have been actually doing that. they're learning how to manage their success. And then more and more success can come. And then they realize, I don't need any success. I've already succeeded. I don't need a succeeder. I've already succeeded. I don't need a leaper. I've already succeeded. I'm already here. I don't need anyone showing me how to get here. I'm already here. Succeeder. I've already succeeded. I need enlightenment. I know I'm already enlightened. So just continue to manage your success. We've already got this advice here. I don't need enlightenment. I'm already enlightened. I don't need success. I'm already successful. I don't need to finish the path. I've already finished. Finish anything that's already finished. That's great. I prefer the natural soundtrack to putting music in, really. Way better. Won't flag this faint background mariachi music or whatever. I wouldn't put it past them, you know. Very sensitive analytics. Maybe they'll say, that's a Black and Decker or a grinder or whatever. You can't have that on there. It's proprietary sound of a Black and Decker grinder. Block. Worldwide blocked and all these. You can't have that bird chirping. That's copyrighted. The sound of that bird is copyrighted. That's where we're going. I don't need freedom, I'm already free. I don't need safety, I'm already safe. There you go, I don't need any safety, I'm already safe. Put that in your pipe and smoke it. I don't need safety, I'm already safe. You know, you don't need to be a drug hero. Put these affirmations in your pipe and smoke these affirmations. Then you'll find out what you're really made of. I don't need safety. I'm already safe. I know I'm already safe. I don't need inclusiveness. I know I'm already included. I don't need prosperity. I know I already have everything. So clean out your pipes and put these affirmations in your pipe. Because these have a greater depth, you see. It's not superficial, it's the depth of it. And this is the wow. The wow is like, wow, the depth of this, the extent, the generalization. Wow, I just, it's beyond my concepts.